Today we take a dive into the genre of Asian literature as we examine a work from one of the most famous, or infamous, depending on who you ask, authors of the last century, Salman Rushdie. As we will soon find out, Salman Rushdie was a polarizing figure whose life work sparked much controversy, discussion, and even violence at times. The majority of Rushdie's controversy is centered around his writing of the Satanic Verses, which openly criticized Islam. However, Rushdie wrote another work that, depending on interpretation, could also be considered to criticize Islam, but did not spark as much controversy. The Prophet's Hair is a mystical story that follows the many tragedies that occur to the people who come into contact with the stolen lock of Prophet Muhammad's hair. This lecture will focus on the more technical aspects of the work, as well as how it relates to Salman Rushdie's past history and personal beliefs. Now, looking at the bigger picture, we can examine the genre that the Prophet's hair falls under. The genre of Asian literature consists of works about Asian cultures, morals, traditions, and different aspects of Asian ideology. You may recall the Ramayana of Valmiki or the Epic of Gilgamesh from last semester. Both of these reflect Asian literature as they focused on Hinduism and its morals. Referring back to the Prophet's hair, it can be categorized into Asian literature because it portrays the principles of Islam. Islam is a major religion in most Asian countries, and those who follow Islam are called Muslims. We can infer that Hashim, as well as the other characters in our short story, are Muslim because the hair that Hashim found was Prophet Muhammad's. Prophet Muhammad is a person who is highly significant in Islam because those who are Muslim believe he is God's messenger, or someone who delivers information from God to the people. Islam is known to promote peace, honesty, and good character. However, Hashim did not return Prophet Muhammad's hair back to the place it belongs. By making the poor decision of keeping the relic, it displays actions that are opposite to what Islam preaches. As we discussed before, Salman Rushdie is known for writing works of literature that contradict the beliefs of Islam. However, the Prophet's hair seems to be different, as Hashim wasn't a religious person at the beginning of the short story, but the strand of hair and the adventures that went along with it changed Hashim into a religiously devoted person. Hashim truly did mentally transform because of this sacred relic, and this work differs from Rushdie's other work because it does not necessarily place Islam in a negative light. It shows that Prophet Muhammad's hair had such a significance towards Hashim, and thus accentuates how powerful Muhammad is for Muslims. Overall, by displaying Islamic culture and including Prophet Muhammad in this text, the Prophet's hair is considered to be a part of Asian literature.
Looking at the historical context of this short story, Salman Rushdie wrote The Prophet's Hair in postmodern terms. This means that he took Islamic traditional views such as having deep faith, being honest, and he twisted them into a westernized point of view. Hashim and his family were westernized as he was a moneylender and his children were portrayed as greedy and spoiled. They were not religious by any means. When the short story was written in 1981, people who were traditional Muslims viewed the story to be very controversial. There were traditional Muslims who believe that Prophet Muhammad's body is kept in the holy city of Medina, Saudi Arabia. It is impossible for someone to obtain Prophet Muhammad's hair as it is kept in a confidential, private area. An individual can look at his grave, but there is no way of accessing it. Therefore, the way Hashim found the sacred relic and took it with him is unethical from a Muslim's point of view and highly impossible. Additionally, Muslims believe that Prophet Muhammad was of high significance, but a strand of his hair would not be able to do the miracles that it did to Hashim. As mentioned earlier, Prophet Muhammad was God's messenger, so God has more authority over him. By seeing Prophet Muhammad's hair, or him in general, can perform miracles and do magical things by himself is unethical in the context of Islam. In Islam, only God can do these miracles, and if God commands Prophet Muhammad, then only then, and only then, would Prophet Muhammad be able to do the miracle. Prophet Muhammad himself does not have enough power or strength as God himself. Thus, when a traditional Muslim sees the short story, They are shocked to see how many inconsistencies there are between the westernized version and Islam itself.
As mentioned previously, Salman Rushdie is a controversial author. Rushdie first garnered infamy when he published The Satanic Verses in 1988. The Satanic Verses was a book that openly criticized Islam and the Prophet Muhammad, therefore breaking the rules of Islam. As could be expected, the Muslim community was outraged by Rushdie's comments. Resultantly, a fatwa which ordered all Muslims to murder Rushdie and anyone else involved with the publishing of the Satanic Verses was issued by Iran's, and please excuse my pronunciation here, Ayatollah Khomeini. Being a former Muslim, Rushdie was painted as a traitor and blasphemous individual by the Muslim community. After receiving a fatwa and multiple death threats, Rushdie was forced to go into hiding under police protection in Great Britain, where he stayed for roughly 10 years. As one might expect, Rushdie grew further and further apart from the Muslim community during his many years in hiding. Now no longer in hiding and an atheist, Rushdie continues to criticize Islam on the basis of Western ideals such as freedom of speech and religion, two liberties he was not afforded as a Muslim. While reading The Prophet's Hair, keep an eye out for any anti-Islamic themes and aspects of the short story that reflect Rushdie's feelings towards and experiences with Islam.
Throughout The Prophet's Hair, Salman Rushdie builds on major themes such as religion or anti-Islam and the consequences of selfish decisions, giving the story greater depth and meaning behind the events of the short story. To start off, religion, specifically Islam, stands out as one of the most prominent themes within the text. For example, Hashim, the moneylender who kept the sacred relic, the Prophet's hair, claims to be honorable and makes himself out to be faithful to his Islam religion, although his actions towards the debtors are rather harsh and threatening. In addition, his moneylending job is considered to be a forbidden business according to the Quran. This reveals truth within societies that follow a religion and how there are some people who only externally seem faithful to appeal to others while not genuinely aligning with the faith internally. Rushdie may be suggesting that this is the case within Islam, criticizing those in the Muslim community. Another major theme that Salman Rushdie emphasizes is the consequences of a religiously unjust and selfish decision. Although the Prophet's hair is considered a holy relic that is meant to serve as an object of blessings, the hair actually serves as a source of bad luck when not in its proper place, the shrine. After Hashim decides to keep the relic, several unfortunate events occur, including many deaths. Salman Rushdie characterizes the sacred object as detrimental rather than beneficial. Muslims praise the Prophet Muhammad. They believe his garments, shoes, and personal effects were understood to have curative powers, or symbols such as his seal or footprint should be valued, such as his hair. However, the hair provides the opposite when stolen, which demonstrates Rushdie's questioning of Muslim beliefs and builds on the themes of anti-Islam and consequences for immoral decisions.